the Fizz.
This matchup's a little bit different than previous when they toned down Fizz's numbers, made his ult damage.
Earning that MVP, having a really wonderful performance on the Swain. Now going and done though, Durant's gonna go down very similarly.
Against ESC, but you don't blind pick Twisted Fate against SK Telecom.
Oh, bless. Speaking of blind, goes straight in to try to clear out that big ward. He gets popped up by Chaser. He's on the run, has the flash down, will be able to repel over to the Wolves.
Nicely done.
Yep, so that's a flash down for Coco. Bar ultimate not going to connect, but here comes the Destiny. Comes in with the gold card, locks him up, has the damage coming through. That's going to be first blood going over to the Twisted Fate, and now the flash away from Totoro. Doesn't matter. He gets locked up and taken down by
Chaser. It's such a big item advantage that he couldn't even win the skirmishes 2v2. This is really smart from Longju, rotating around the no way clear.
A ton of damage, has the flash away, so Temp will not be able to finalize the kill. Bless gets locked up, he's gonna go down, and Chaser finds the kill.
Bless got no combat stats, we made it do.
Yeah, and Temp's been just playing really interesting. Oh boy, uses the troll pole, Bard ultimate comes out, Destiny straight down to the middle of that one. He's gonna get locked up, and he is gonna fall. Question is who gets the kill. It's gonna be Pure yet again, killing him with the Ignite, and Expression comes through. Trying to find a target for the Never, but will find Totoro. He doesn't come in time, so he doesn't even get the assist, but...
Our opponents, which is not something we've been able to say about Longju, but...
Not at all.
They're reading Ever like a book and playing them like a fiddle, and they rotated around the no escape Fizz, almost took mid lane turret the first time. They do get it the second time, and some...
Spit apples in there. It was, that was the weirdest...
Carlito Caribbean.
That was like the weirdest shtick that you could bar lives.
A lot of people really died from wrestling as
well,
unfortunately.
Well, that's true. Well, that leads...
...in the game. And... Yeah, they just continue pushing forward. They want to take down Bless.
Yeah, they're looking for it, but the tunnel's already been used there by Chaser, so he can't get over.
I mean, what's happening?
Don't worry about it. It's like watching Ghost in the Shell. Oh, Chaser. He's going to get locked up. The Glacial Fisher doesn't connect, though.
He's
one last turret shot. He's got him. That's going to be Loken picking up the kill credits. So Chaser got to be feeling a little silly about that one. So back, so there's no smite. They just have the damage up front, so they're going to be able to take it down.
A calming phase.
Oh, here we go. TP in with the Destiny as
really
well.
Nice
Loken
going
to get locked up. He's trying to run out of here. Looks like they might just have to turn tail, pick up somebody else. No, the Never move does connect, and Loken's going to go down. Chaser finding the kill. Chloe comes across, and Totoro gets locked up. That's going to be a double kill going over to the Rek'Sai, and this looks like...
I mean, there's nothing he could have done with a teleport, so...
Oh,
Pure might win this.
He's going to 1v1 Bless.
Go, Pure. Get him.
My God.
Oh, he repels the damage.
Oh, he goes down. That's unfortunate.
I just worry for them, because the scouting pot's going to be so obvious. Chase has got super aggressive.
Yeah, he gets locked up by the cocoon, but it doesn't matter because the turret's still going to go down. Coco finds a gold card onto Crazy, but the Never Move's not going to connect. Right up in the face is the Glacial Fissure, but it doesn't matter. That's still Totoro going down. And I really don't think that ESC can try to defend this.
I mean, Chaser still has Guardian Energy. He rushed it so they could keep going for these aggressive
dives. Oh, flashes straight onto Bless and gets the kill, takes him down. It's going to be Coco using the Zonius to get away from that jump to waters. Attempt on the run. Two more hits should do it, but Fury just can't find the gap close. But Crazy has to flash away as well. And looks like this might just be the end of the game coming up here. 30 seconds still on Bless. Do they stick around? They have the Baron buff. They're going over onto the Nexus turrets. But Longju are going to go ahead and play this safely. A bunch of a minion wave here, but they will still be able to finish it off. Loken gets caught. Oh, that's going to be devastating. Chaser's already ready to go with a knockup, as is the Never move. He goes down. Expression finds the kill. Two members already falling as ESC just scramble back towards the fountain. Look at this, Swain. Doesn't give a good golly goddamn. Just pushes straight up into the face of the remaining members of ESC. And with these super creeps coming in the bottom side, looks like Longju are going to find a 2-0 finish. Taking down game two in just about 31 minutes.
No wave clear left for ESC, but they didn't have a lot. They have absolutely none now. Let's get some bonus kills to get up there in the KDA rankings. Everyone's going to have a bit of fun.
Got to pad those stats. We'll find a couple extra kills. Crazy, the only one left alive, just sitting in the base, wondering, like, man, how did my team lose so hard?
But an immaculate win. 1-6, I believe, coming into this game. Looking over
but
at the numbers.
They have played more games.
Lucian.
Okay, so yeah, this time.
Three people doing more damage than anyone on the side of Ever.
That's really rough.
And the most damage was on Elise. That's awful.
Wow, yeah. And even so, Coco, very much the utility Twisted Fate, creating picks using the Destiny and applying pressure that way, getting those gold card stunts for everybody else to dish out the damage and find the kills. So not a huge damage figure from him, but certainly involved in the game.